Forget about it. Forget. That's a key to winning as a Christ-pursuing coach. Can you believe that? Forgetfulness. Well, I remember when I was playing baseball in college and we were playing our arch rival, and it was the top of the last inning, and we were up by a run, and there were two runners on, and a ground ball is hit to me, and the ball literally went right between my legs. Two runners came around to score, and the other team went up by one. And lo and behold, after we got the third out, there were two outs in the bottom of the last inning, and who was up to the plate? Yours truly. Now, what did I have to do in that moment? I had to forget what had happened before so that I could look forward to what was right in front of me. We have to be a people, as athletes and coaches, who have to do a lot of forgetting because we do a lot of failing. And the same is true in our Christian life and in our Christian leadership. We forget what is behind us. That rottenness, those bad decisions and mistake and foolishness that we have experienced and are guilty of in our lives. And we got to flush all of that and look forward to what lies ahead. Just like Paul said, that's what we do. Because this is the thing, is we're not who we once used to be. That's not who we are. We are who Christ says we are, His children, His sons, His daughters, and now His ambassadors. Listen, a lot of coaches don't lead for the glory of God because they have a past that they think they can't get over and they can't lead for Jesus. That's hogwash. That comes from Satan. Everybody has a testimony who knows Jesus, and we can lead for Him no matter where we've been, because it's not where we've been, it's where we are in the position of the kingdom and where we're headed toward Jesus Christ. Remember that today, coach, and lead with confidence as you forget what lies behind and strain toward what lies ahead.